No price talk and no Lambos. This is not another crypto podcast. Welcome to Ignition. I'm your host, Gillian Godsell, and each week we will be looking at the problems solved by blockchain. I'll be going deep, deep with the people building the apps and communities which are changing the world around us. Good morning, good morning. You're listening to the EOS Dublin podcast, Ignition, with me, Gillian Godsell. And today I have a good friend on the call, actually. His Shiv Agarwal, who's the CEO and founder of My Earth ID. So Shiv, welcome to the program.
Thank you very much, Gillian.
So I know all about you, but our listeners at EOS Dublin might not. So tell me about your background, your career, etc., and how you ended up in London.
Okay. Actually, I'm a technologist at heart with over 14 years of IT industry experience. And actually, my experience primarily lies in defining IT strategy roadmap and solutions of big enterprises, right? So I've worked with major blue chip organizations like Bank of America across India, UK, and US. I actually come from a family business. And then that is where I always felt that I have an entrepreneurial blood, right? And then I kept tinkering with different ideas. But I took my first step towards entrepreneurship when I started QMA Consulting in 2015. So since then, I've been working with different size of projects. And then my focus was basically clouds, APIs, so all the latest technology, right? And that is where I basically moved into blockchain and cryptocurrencies.
I was going to ask you that. Yeah. So where did you first hear about blockchain? Did it impress you when you first bumped into it?
Yeah. So I think for most of us, right? So we came to know about blockchain and related technologies due to the hype of Bitcoin, right? That, okay, mm-hmm. it's making so much money. People are buying Lamborghinis, right? So that is where I came to know about Bitcoin. But then given my technology background, my interest was not limited to financial gains and tried to understand the hypothesis behind Bitcoin and the technology it brought to life. See, the thing is what attracted me most was basically the fundamental idea of decentralization, right? The idea that we don't really have to trust people or organizations for the exchange of value. If you think about this, the world cannot run without trust and rules, right? Because otherwise it would be an utter chaos. However, that doesn't mean that we have to put our trust in the hands of faltering people and organizations. So we have technology at our disposal, and I'm a technologist, right? And that is where we can say that technology is totally compliant and unbiased, and then we can actually put our trust in the technology.
It's cool, yes. It's all math-based, isn't it? It's quite a nice thing. You don't have to worry about, do you trust an entity or an institution? It's the maths. Either.
Exactly.
It doesn't tell lies. So tell me, you've actually gone one step further as well. You actually have a project on blockchain. Tell me about My Earth ID. It's a pretty big project.
Yes, we have a very, very bold vision. So My Earth ID is working on a mission to simplify the process of identity management through a use of a universal identity platform, right? So our primary goal is to reduce identity thefts and frauds and to use cryptography and blockchain technology and to reduce the overall cost and complexity associated with maintaining and validating identities. Vision of Earth ID is to onboard every human being on Earth onto this new identity management platform so that we can provide seamless access and hassle-free access to people all over the world, irrespective of whether it's an offline or an online service.
And there's also elements of rating. Is that correct? So you can build up a reputation on
My Earth. Yes. So it's a very key aspect of My Earth ID, actually. So we have this concept of trust score, which is like an identity quotient. So as of today, when we talk about identity, it's like always yes or no. But then what trust score does it like? So basically, it provides a rating to an individual with respect to the information they have shared, their identity information, and then the way they behave across platforms, and then how often they use Earth ID as their identity across partners, right? So we have a proprietary algorithm which would basically assign a score to every individual, and then on the basis of that score, different service providers or organizations and industries, they can actually rate their services, and then they can basically say, okay, which services can be accessed by which human beings, and then also they can actually create a charging model across that as well. So it's just like you can do more with a trust score than just a yes and no kind of identity.
So there's more complexity and depth.
Yes.
So tell me, we're on the EOS podcast. How did you find out about EOS and what impresses you about this technology?
So since I'm working in this blockchain industry very actively, right? So it's natural for me to basically follow up what's happening in the industry. And I think EOS has a very great value proposition. and it's making the right noise as well, right? I think it's a next-gen blockchain platform which has the right focus on speed and security and actually building a partners community. And I think that is working really well. I think if I have to specifically talk about technology, I think in that sense, I think the key points are it's open source, it's Byzantine fault tolerance, but it's very secure. And then it is super fast, right? And I think these are the key aspects that we actually look into our technology platform.
That's cool. And because you're a technologist, you're also flirting with Hashcraft. You're flirting with both technologies. We were just talking about marriage before we started recording. I don't know. You're having an affair. What do you like about Hashcraft then? And can the two be used together, or what would you do?
Right. Yeah. So basically, see, when we started EarthID, we were looking for a platform which can actually scale up with the needs of the EarthID, right? So we have a very bold vision for EarthID, and that is where we wanted a platform which is very fast, very reliable, and very safe. Because see, we are handling identity information, and it has its own pitfalls, right? And that is where Hashgraph ticked all the boxes, and we also have a strategic collaboration with them, right? And that is where we get more additional benefits. But if I have to talk about two platforms, we are not necessarily looking at them as choices. We are actually looking at them as basically two platforms which can actually play a specific role in basically the overall EarthID as a identity management platform, right? So what I am thinking as a technologist, or maybe as a CEO of the company, I'm looking at two technologies which have a specific use case to solve. And so I'm thinking basically Hashgraph is kind of helping us build the underlying platform to exchange identity information. And then EOS can actually play a potential role of being the token and smart contracts platform. So it's basically about playing the strength of each platform rather than basically deciding, okay, you have to go with only one platform. That is like marrying two platforms to get the best out of it.
Well, it's an interesting approach, isn't it? Because oftentimes people fall with one or the other. You know, they go, I'm going with this one or I'm going with that one, and they don't marry them. So it is interesting. So in offline, you're also doing stuff. You're a member of the Government Blockchain Association. Who are they, and what is the advantage of belonging to that association?
Okay. So Government Blockchain Association is an international non-profit organization which is actually working with governments and public sector professionals to help them adopt blockchain as a technology, right? And then reap the benefits. Because obviously, I think most of the organization, if you think about, they are kind of private in the sense that they are doing their own business or more industry focused. This is one organization which is helping government bodies to adopt blockchain. GB has actually a lot of working groups which are focused on different use cases like identity and others. And then they have a very big community because they have local chapters across the world. I'm actually leading their identity working group and then Hashgraph community. So in that sense, I'm working very closely with them. Actually, being part of GBA allows you to basically access to a great network of industry professionals, because if you look at this, if you look at them, they have a very good network across the world. And then also you are getting access to a lot of invaluable resources and artifacts. And then you also, on top of that, basically, you get a platform where you can actually help making the change further with respect to blockchain technology. So basically, blockchain technology has a specific purpose, and this is kind of furthering the interests of all the people who are involved in this community.
That's brilliant. So it is so important to network, because it's a very small community, but sometimes there's gaps. I mean, like, how are you finding trying to build your team? Is that an easy job or is it a difficult job?
Actually, I think it's a tough ask, but then I think it is the most important aspect of any business, right? So see, given we are talking about blockchain, so there are a lot of good ideas in the market, but I think everybody accepts this fact that the success lies in the execution, and that is where you need a very strong team. And then that is why building the team is my first priority, right? So, and the best part for us is like people get really excited with the vision and mission of EarthID, and they are eager to join us. And that is where we have already built a global team across, which basically a team of industry leaders and experts, which are spread across US, UK, Ireland, Bulgaria, India, and we are still expanding. So in that sense, yeah, it's difficult, but it's happening for us.
And what about the bear market? I mean, is that negatively impacting your desire to raise funds? I presume it must be. I mean, it's affecting everybody. How bad is it for you?
It is. So it has been a tough summer, and then looking at the market, I think it's going to be tougher ahead of us, right? But having said that, it's not all grim. EarthID is getting the right traction. We are actually under discussion with a few potential investors. See, our strategy is to basically think big and start small to ensure that we prove the value, right? And the current focus is basically building strong foundation with respect to team and partnership. And then once we have a very strong foundation, that is where I think we can go to the market or go to the investors and say, okay, this is what we are doing. And that is where I think we are getting the right traction.
Yes. And what advice would you give to entrepreneurs in the same space? Not necessarily blockchain, but general business advice about setting up your own project.
I'll sound very boring, but then I think I would say stick to the basics. Believe in yourself, in your idea. Get the right people on the team, and then be sincere and persistent, right? So, and also basically give less heed to all the conversations around Lambo and Bloodbath, all those stories. I think blockchain is a technology which is going to stay, right? It is going to change the way we exchange value with each other. So that is where I think just focus on what you are doing and then just keep doing it.
Okay. And is there anything you would do differently so far on your journey? What have you learned from any mistakes that you've made?
Honestly speaking, I'm quite pleased with the way we are running EarthID, and we are actually sticking to the basics and building strong foundations. We can always argue about the market, right? But then that's the risk every business has to live with. So in that sense, I think we are making good progress.
Good, good. And tell me, if people want to find out about your project online, where can they find you?
So they can actually go to myearth.id, that is the website, or they can always follow me on LinkedIn and then they can go from there.
Okay. Well, so thank you so much for your time today, Shiv. It's a pleasure as always to chat with you.
Thank you very much, Gillian. Thanks for having me on the road.
Thank you. And that's Shiv Agarwal, CEO and founder of MyEarthID.